Welcome back. You're watching NHL Tonight. The Florida Panthers, despite a late charge in the second half of the season, missing the playoffs by just a single point, finishing with 96 points in their first season under head coach Bob Boughner. You can see their points percentage following the All-Star game. Look at 25 wins, best in the Eastern Conference during that span. 34.4 shots per game. That's tied for first in the NHL. Panthers coach Bob Boughner joining us on the show right now. Bob, you recently hosted your annual Black Tie Tailgate, which we understand is a blue-collar version of a black tie affair. And after seeing some of the pictures, we got to admit, you can rock the cowboy hat. Tell us about that charity event.
Well, this is the third time we did it. The Black Tie Tailgate is an event that we put together through our Windsor Spitfires Foundation, along with We Care for Kids. And it's raised a lot of money over the last few years. I believe this year is between $125,000 and $130,000. And it all goes to local charity, children's charity in our community. It's a fun event with a lot of our friends and people that are loyal to the Spitfire organization, but also people that are just successful in the city that support our city and all those charities. So a lot of fun, and we're going to do it again next year.
Bob, slow start to the season last year. Incredible second half. How do you prevent a slow start to this upcoming season?
Well, that's our job as coaches. I think in the last little while, we've been talking about how we're going to address the team, the message from the onset here of training camp. And there's a few things we're going to look to tweak and tighten up defensively. But it's not going to be a major change in our systems. I think, the players being familiar with the X's and O's and what our expectations are. But let's face it, expectations have changed from last year to this year. And that's right from ownership to management to coaches. And I'm sure the players themselves.
What did you learn your first year behind the bench down there? We always ask the players after their first season, but what did you as a coach learn about yourself?
I think if I had to do it all over again, one of the things I would have done is make it some adjustments a little sooner on. I think that our team started going in the right direction when we finally put Johnny Huberdeau on the line with Trocheck. We separated that big line of Dadonov, Barkov, and Huberdeau, and it just gave us some more balance through our lineup. So things maybe making adjustments a little bit quicker, but you look back and you ask yourself the reasons why we got off to a slow start, and a lot of teams are in the same boat, but you got to stay healthy. And when we lost Louis there for, I think 35, 40 games at the beginning of the season, it was tough. And we weren't playing as good defensively. But in the second half, we got our act together. And that's just got to happen from day one. We're not going to go 25-8-2 in our first, 35 games or so. But we have to be realistic, and we have to make sure that we're in the hunt early.
Bob, you talked about losing Luongo for the portion of the season. You have three goaltenders on one-way contract. You have Luongo, Reimer, and now Michael Hutchinson comes into the fold. What's your plans with the goaltenders? And is there a chance that there will be three goaltenders on the roster?
Well, there's always a chance. I think that, it's going to play itself out in training camp. I think that, we know obviously Louis and Rhymes can do, and Hutch has had had a great year last year, and he's been around the game for a long time too. It's just good to have stability in the organization at that position. Montembeau is a good young goaltender in the American League for us, a guy that needs, a year or two of getting his game to where it needs to be to be up with the big clubs. So we're excited for his future, but we need some depth, and in case something happens again, we have we have that in that position now.
You talk about depth. How about up front, your top six? You add a guy like Mike Hoffman, who can certainly put the puck in the back of the net. How dangerous can your top six be going into this season?
Yeah, we're encouraged by having our top six. I think if there was a hole on our team last year, it was that winger on the top six setup. So now we have Hoff, and obviously he's going to help our power play. He's one of the best shooters in the NHL. He adds to our team speed. We like to play fast. And I think I'm excited for our top six. And what it does is just pushes other guys down to our bottom six where we need depth as well. And we have to have, good four lines. We want to roll four lines. We don't want to be a three-line team. And I think that's just going to help. We're getting better.
Talk about that bottom six. You have Vetrano down there. You're being Brouwer. You got Letestu coming in on a PTO to training camp. You have a plethora of bodies, a lot of options. How intense is this training camp going to be?
Well, that's another one of the messages early on. I think last year at this time, you know, guys were sort of slotted into where they were going to be. There wasn't a ton of competition in camp. This year, it's quite different. There's going to be some competition for jobs. There's going to be a battle of not only just being on the roster, but where are you going to play? Where do you fit into our lineup? And I think that that's healthy competition. I think that you're going to see that right through preseason. I think it's going to push a lot of guys. Again, we talk about having a good start to the season. I think it's going to push a lot of guys to be ready early on.
All right, as you told us earlier, you're ready, chomping at the bit. We are too. So enjoy what's left of your summer, your off season, and we wish you the best of luck in the upcoming season down in Florida, okay?
I appreciate that. Thanks for having me.